They're tightening up. First laps under competition of the 2015 Ultima season. Here we go. Quickly to the lead will be Arp. Ellis down to the inside. They're scattering out two and three wide back through the field. Watch that top side, the 343 of Parker. A little bit of contact there with Casey Berra. He slides through. First lap was in the books. Got one up against the outside wall. It's the 13 of Mashburn. He may have more than just a tire, smoke off the tire. That could be an engine going away. Two laps in, going eight. Here we go, green flag back in the air. Arpa lead them back down to one. Ellis in the second spot. Ellis on the very bottom. Ridley tried the high side. It's going to allow White to work to the inside. Ross White's work to the inside of Ridley. Dodson, McPherson, the 29, also working to the inside. Caution on the speedway. Got the believe that's Dillard. Randy Dillard goes around in turn four.
Eric Ellis.
Aaron Ridley. Ross White. Rambo. Barra and Sykes. Here we go. Glenn Elliott, excuse me. They're three wide for that transfer position. Ridley slides high. Ellis, Ross White. Ellis trying to put a little heat on the veteran Skip Arp. Car slides up the hill off of turn two. Ross White giving up a position to Rambo Dennis Franklin. Rambo moves to fourth. White there in the zero car. He's in the fifth spot, still safely in the field. Skip Arp working the middle of the speedway, both ends. Derek Ellis on the very bottom, throwing both ends of the speedway. Making up a little ground, especially through three and four. Derek Ellis trying to make a run at your leader, and that's it. That's a checkers out right there. Skip Arp, you're a winner, followed by Derek Ellis. Aaron Ridley. Welshen in the 29, Croft in the 9. They'll lead him to green off of turn four. Green flag in the air. Ferguson quickly to the inside. That time he got a hell of a, heck of a jump on the inside. Sorry. Makes his way to the front row. Sorry. Croft to the lead. Ferguson, Welshen, Shirley. Kenny Collins will move into the fourth position. Anthony White in the 2X. That's your transfer spot as he rolls into turn one. Croft pulling away from Ferguson and Welshen. Welshen side by side with Ferguson as they roll back to turn one. Ferguson will let him go. Again, watch the 2X of Anthony White. That is your transfer position. These guys letting it stretch out a little bit. Top six. Say, hey, I'm in this race. I want to just get in there, and then we'll mix it up for the battle. Welshen slides high off of turn two. Keeps it off the wall. White flag in the air for your leader, Jason Croft. He's rocking it down the backstretch. Checkers for Jason Croft. So Jason Croft. Feel being told, McIntosh will set the pace. Off of turn four is where they will get the green flag. Yeah, my name Tommy Tedder. Happy to bring you the action here. Race director Kelly Carlton. Our tech crew tonight was Alton Wilson, CJ Mason, and Randy Reiser. Our scorer is Miss Laura Lemons. Here we go. Green flag getting ready to fly. Going to turn one, McIntosh, OMB side by side. OMB with a good run up on the top side. OMB with the lead as they roll down to turn three. McIntosh over rotates. He'll somehow caught the car. He lost the position. Payne to the second spot. Jason Hyatt in the third position. They're two wide all the way back from there. Coming three wide off of turn four. Ray Cook to the inside. The Tar Heel Tiger trying to make some moves. He moves up to the fifth position. Sixth position. David Payne and McIntosh battling for the second position. McIntosh back to second. But it's John Owenby out front, pulling away from the field. Chris Ferguson has already pulled it to the infield. OMB almost lost it off a turn. OMB sliding up the hill off of turn two every time. McIntosh reeling him in. OMB in lap traffic already. He's working to the inside of Ross White. Good battle for the third position in the A19 and the 8 car. The 19 of Hyatt, Payne in the 8. They're side by side for the third coming off of 4. Payne will hold on to it. McIntosh, spin right in front of the leaders. They are able to make it through. That's your top 10. Here we go. OMB out front. We're getting ready to go green. It's his race to start. He'll gas her up. We're green flag racing. McIntosh down to the very bottom through one. OMB keeps her gassed up on the outside and hangs on to the lead. Casey Roberts to the fourth position in the 101 machine. As soon as I say it, Hyatt worked back to the inside in turn three and four, the A19. Now he's looking to the inside of the 8 of Murphy. Murphy, North Carolina's David Payne. Payne slides a little high. Now Casey Roberts working to the inside of David Payne. Ray Cook trying to work that high side magic. Ray Cook in the 53 car, working to the outside of Riley Hickman in the R1. Jason Hyatt in the A19 has run down your leaders. Caution on the speedway. Got two around over in turn number two. Getting ready to go green. And it is O&B's race to start. He gasses her up. We're back green flag racing. Hyatt with a good jump on that outside. He's quickly to the second spot. He'll slide up the raceway looking for more. But McIntosh going to fight back hard to the inside. Hard battle down into turn three. Red flag. One, two, three, four, five cars, six cars involved over there. Coming green this time. Still 25 laps of racing. OMB holding it low off of turn four this time. Takes a two-car advantage now, zero-car advantage off of turn one. Good bite off of turn two. Hyatt trying to use the top side. He'll stay up on the top shelf. David Payne and Ray Cook also up on the top side. Hyatt and McIntosh battling for that second spot. That's letting O&B get away. Three, four car lengths now. They drive it deep back to turn three. One car facing the wrong direction. Everybody getting her woed up. OMB's race to start. He'll gas her up. We're back. Green flag. OMB with the slide back. Hyatt drives it deep and hard on the outside. He'll go to the second position. Drives it deep again on the outside in three and four. Way up top there is David Payne. Through three and four. Several drivers trying to make that outside groove work. Hyatt, the leader of the outside groove bunch. David Payne in the 8 and Ray Cook in the 53. They both like the top side as well. Riley Hickman, the R1, Ray Cook, good battle for the sixth position. Cook with a slight advantage as they roll down into turn three. McIntosh trying to work back underneath Jason Hyatt. Two X of Anthony White pulls it to the infield on the back straightaway. This time by, it is still OMB out front by about three car lengths over the seven of Donald McIntosh. It is about five back now to the A19 of Jason Hyatt. Couple more back to the 101 of Casey Roberts. OMB catching the tail of the field now. Maybe McIntosh's chance to catch him.
10 to go.
OMB doing a great job with traffic. But he leaves that door open every time for McIntosh just to follow him through. McIntosh lost several car lengths through 3 and 4 that lap pass time. Hedgecock in the 23, slowing on the backstretch. He'll pull it to the infield. Five to go this time by OMB with a tough spot in traffic that time. Five to go. McIntosh going to try to jump it up on the top shelf. When he does, that lets Hyatt get to his inside. OMB keeping it stuck on the bottom, and he has traffic in front of him. That's Bo Shirley in the 111. Hyatt has now worked to the inside of McIntosh. McIntosh still trying to work that outside groove for clear, free traffic. The Hyatt worked underneath him. OMB still out front. Two to go that last time by. John OMB out of Cleveland, Tennessee in the zero car. He'll lead them back to turn one. He's got Jason Hyatt all over the rear bumper. McIntosh there in the third spot. He just gets passed by Roberts. Hyatt goes to the top side, but off of four. John OMB will pick up the win. He's followed by Jason Hyatt. Too close for me to call for the third spot between McIntosh and Roberts. Come on out. John OMB, your winner tonight. Cleveland, Tennessee driver, Longhorn chassis, Phantom Race engine, Sam's Restaurants, M&S Motors. John, tell you what, man, you had her hooked up and rolling tonight. You made that pass at the start, and man, what a way to go tonight.
Yeah, we had a real good car. We was debating on whether to come down here. We run a steel motor. We was afraid it'd be real fast, you know, against the big motors, but it seemed to hook up good. The track suited the car, and I'd like to thank the Lord most of all. He's guided me through this, and he's always there to help me out, and I thank my sponsors. Thank Sam and Glenda Durham for giving me such good equipment to drive, and thank M&S Motors, Phantom Race Engines, man. I tell you what, we put this motor in a couple weeks ago, went to Winchester and won a big race, and now tonight he's putting me some, building some good, putting some good smooth horsepower in there where I can drive it. And I'd like to thank A1 Moving Storage and Longhorn, Matt at Longhorn, Matt's the one that always helps me with what I need to do to it. So, Stealth Carburetors, and I think that's it.
You got them all in there for sure. I tell you what, though, let me ask you this. Could you feel Donald? Could you feel Jason? They were there. They were working high and low there when you got to traffic.
Yeah, when we first took off, it felt like the high side coming off two was going to be good, but I ran a couple laps there, and it kind of like it was blowing off quick, so I got back in the bottom, was trying to just hold the bottom and drive. I wasn't trying to push too hard. I was letting out a little early, just trying to go smooth around the bottom. And it was tricky sometimes. Sometimes you come through and some of them would splash mud out and you'd hit the slime. And I'm like, oh, no, he's going to get under me. But we held in there. So
great job tonight. Congratulations. $4,000 Ultimate Supers tonight. Your winner tonight, Mr. John OMB. We're going to go back here and talk to Jason Hyatt first. Jason, congratulations. Good run. Man, you worked the top side. You worked the bottom side. You worked everywhere but all over him. You were there, man. Just couldn't make it happen.
Yeah, I thought the top was going to blow off there and I could make it work. And I got my right rear tire real hot, and I kind of had to slow down at the bottom there. But, you know, we just pissed around in the top too long, basically. And I still think we had the best car. Just just didn't work out. But if you can keep clicking off top threes, you're going to get a few every once in a while. So,
for sure. New ride for you this year, is am I right? When they said Jason Hott in the one, I'm used to Jason Hott in the one car.
Yeah, we're driving for Richard here. I got to thank him for putting me in the car, and Vincent Race Engines and Phillips Properties.
Congratulations. Good, strong second place run. Fun to watch you tonight. Let's go down here and talk to McIntosh as well. He also had a good night there at the end, working high, low, middle. Donald, you ran everywhere you could trying to make it up, and maybe lost a position there at the end trying to work the high side to get by him in traffic.
Yeah, I mean, I'm always going for the win. I wasn't worried about holding a second, so I thought maybe I could roll him on the top, but had a great car tonight. I think we were a little bit wrong on tire choice, but I can't thank David and BJ enough. They make the right call so much that I can't complain, but still an awesome night for us. I love his new car. Rocket's done a great job. I can't thank Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, Stowers Cat, Vic Hill Race Engines, and everybody that helps us out. It's pretty awesome to be here, and man, I'm so blessed, and may the glory be to God.
Congratulations, Donald. Great, strong third-place run tonight. Donald McIntosh, your third-place runner tonight.